Hey guys, welcome to Mad Scientist BBQ. I'm Jeremy Yoder, and today I'm going to show you how this disgusting blob is going to be the best thing you grill all year. I recently went to Argentina, spent just over 2 weeks there, and had an amazing time and got to eat amazing food. One of the truly amazing things I had there was something called mollejas. So in kind of Argentine Spanish, that's what they use to refer to what we call the thymus gland, or more commonly when cooking, sweetbreads. I was kind of adventurous there, kind of whatever people put in front of me, I tried. I tried beef kidney, actually. That was even worse than you might think it is. It really tasted like there was a cow peeing in your mouth. Disgusting. Do not recommend. But mollejas, even though it's kind of different than anything I'd previously grilled before, I took the first bite and I realized, oh my goodness, it is absolutely incredible. And so I started talking to my buddy Al. I was like, Al, where can I get these in the United States? And he gave me some tips. And I decided I have got to cook some of these because it was the best bite of food I had in the entire country of Argentina. It's not an exaggeration. Everybody who went on the trip with me would agree. They were doing like fillets and a bunch of incredible cuts of beef, and everybody wanted more mollejas. By the way, if you guys are interested in the class that Al and I will be doing in Texas on April 13th, I'll put a link for that in the description. You're going to be spending a day with me and Al. You're going to do some offset smoker cooking, some open fire Argentine style cooking, and there's a dinner the night before and a brunch the morning after. But if you're interested in that, link is in the description. Let's get this box open and see what we're working with.
Gross. It looks like brains.
Easy peel corner. Also, one thing it's important to note while I get these out of the package, in Argentina, they slaughter cattle at a much younger age, and so they get bigger sweetbreads. The older the cattle are, the smaller the sweetbreads become, and in this case, in the United States, I got veal sweetbreads. I think that the thymus gland is part of the immune system. Caveat, I'm no medical doctor, this is not medical advice. Okay, I like to cook meat with fire. Or, in some cases, I like to cook sweetbreads with fire. So I'm going to get this out, and we're going to take a look at this, and as disgusting as this thing looks when it comes out of the package, it is even more delicious when you're done. And the beauty of the whole thing is it is the simplest thing in the entire world to cook. It's salt, a fire, and some lemon, and you can get this done. So here we have this, what looks like a disgusting blob of gelatinous disgustingness. Easy peel corner of my eyebrow. Yeah, easy cut with a very sharp knife. Ooh, ew. This is a big gross one. Should we do it again?
No.
As you guys can see, it's not the most appetizing cut. I've had this like a dozen times, and every time it's been absolutely incredible, and even I'm skeptical by looking at it. But never fear, this is gonna be incredible. You guys can do this on a Weber kettle. You can do it on a ChudBox like I'm using today. You can do it on any kind of grill that you have. I would recommend that you use charcoal because you get tons of that radiant heat and it typically browns this up better. Today on the ChudBox, we're using a combination of wood and charcoal. Let's get these things prepped, which is gonna be incredibly simple. All you need is some salt. I took a lot of worthless classes in high school and college. Probably 90% of the classes I took were not as valuable as taking a single personal finance class. And one of the things that I've had to learn as an adult is the importance of life insurance, especially after getting married, especially after having kids. And I want to thank today's sponsor, Policy Genius, for making that process easy and allowing me to save money. Policy Genius has licensed award-winning agents that make it easy to compare life insurance policies from our nation's top insurers so you can find the best policy for you at the best price. Even if you already have a life insurance policy through work, it may not give you enough coverage, or it could be the case that if you ever leave that job, you're no longer covered, so it might be to your benefit and definitely to the benefit of those who rely on your income to get a second policy, and there's no better place than Policy Genius. With Policy Genius, you can find life insurance policies starting at just $292 per year for $1 million of coverage. Some options offer same-day approval and avoid unnecessary medical exams. Policy Genius has thousands of five-star reviews on Google and Trustpilot from satisfied customers who are able to find the right fit for their needs. Save time and money and provide your family with the financial safety net that they need by using Policy Genius. Just go to policygenius.com/madscientistbbq or click on the link in the description and get a free quote and see how you can start saving today. What I'm going to do is some coarse salt. You can use Diamond Crystal, you can use Morton's, you can use whatever salt you want. The only thing you have to do is salt it. And don't go super heavy, but don't be afraid of over-salting. So I'll show you kind of what I'm looking at here. flip them over, and do it again. Go back, Jack, do it again. This side somehow looks even more disgusting. You know what's gotta be good if it looks this gross and people are still willing to eat it? Here in the Chud Box, I got a mix of oak charcoal and oak wood that's burned into coals. I'm gonna start off at about 375, 400 degrees. And what I'm after when these are done, I want them to be golden brown all on the outside. And with these sweetbreads, what you do is you end up way overcooking it by traditional standards. Because what we're trying to do is get a beautiful crust, kind of like a French fry would look on the outside. Beautiful, dark, golden brown. And I'll give you guys a temp for when these are actually done. In Argentina, there are no thermometers. But for the mere mortals among us, I use my ThermoPen 1. By the way, if you ever thought about getting one right now, the best deal you'll find anywhere on any channel, any website, any anything is in the link in my description. It ends at the end of this month, so get on it while you can. Anyway, I'm gonna get these guys onto this Chud Box and we're gonna start grilling. Grill. Mollejas. The two things that I'm doing, that I'm thinking about right now, number one is I have the lid open to the grill because in Argentina, they're trying to brown that side before it gets cooked all the way through. So these do get overcooked in maybe a technical sense, but they're not dry, they don't dry out. They're crispy on the outside and soft on the inside. Think of a French fry, but way more delicious. And the second thing is, I'm not gonna touch these things until they cook enough on that bottom side so that they release from the grate. Because if you try to move them around too soon, you're gonna have meat, well, you're gonna have sweet bread that sticks to the grate and you're gonna be fighting with it. Let it sit, give it some time. It's gonna be probably 10 minutes before I even take a look at the underside of these things. It's been about 10, 12 minutes and I'm gonna see if these are starting to release yet. No, I'm still pretty stuck. This one's almost ready to release. This one's released. But we want golden brown all the way around, but we can flip this around and kind of cook, flip, kind of like the just keep flipping method on steaks. See this guy, that one's released. And so when these kind of release, this one's almost ready to release. When they release, I'll flip these two. So got two flipped over, and we're gonna keep flipping back and forth until we have golden brown. Apparently the entire neighborhood felt that today was the day to do yard work. What are you gonna do? There we go. I just opened up the door and I stirred the coals around because I want oxygen to get in there and I want those coals to really wake up and start producing a lot of heat because now we're after that golden brown. We could kind of have browning on one side, starting to get browning on the other. And now we're gonna go in with the secret weapon. So sprayable Wagyu towel. You can use olive oil, you can use whatever you want. I love the taste of this stuff. So we're gonna hit both sides with this, and you can actually do this before you start to prevent any sticking. I probably should have. If I were doing it again, I would recommend that. But this is gonna give us that super tasty outside crust so that when you take a bite, you get the crispness, and then the inside is just this beautiful, soft, buttery texture. Anyway, let's do it. Now that we brought the temperature up relatively gently, now it's time to get that crust on the outside so you have some crispiness and then the soft interior. So I'm gonna put a log on these coals to really ramp up the temperature in there. And then I'm gonna put those mollejas a little further away so they're not directly over the flame and get burned, but I want it just ripping hot in there, 500 degrees plus, super toasty. See the yellow again, that's that crust. All right, so we just have a short period of time at super high heat. We're gonna get these things finished off. These are looking tasty. That's what we wanna see. This is exactly what we want. We wanna see that crispy golden color. That is precisely the texture on the outside we want. That looks nice. Got it?
Yeah.
Yeah. In Argentina, they don't use thermometers, but I snuck one along, and the temperature that they were pulling these things off at was just over 200 degrees. So I think four of these are done, and then one is almost done. It's at 190. If you guys want to get the best deal possible on a ThermoPen one, there's a link in the description. You're not going to find a better deal on any website, any influencer channel. That is the best deal you're going to find anywhere. So if you ever thought about getting a ThermoPen one, now's the time. All right, and that is it for the cooking process. We have a crust on the outside, listen here. And the inside is very soft. That's exactly what we're looking for. Just salt on the outside. Last thing to do is we're gonna cut a lemon in half and drizzle some lemon juice on the top, and you're ready to rock and roll. So I'm gonna move these out of the way a little bit. So here we have a little bit of red color because we used a little bit of wood and we added some charcoal, and so it kind of gave it that reddish smoked color. The only difference in doing it with an Argentine grill is it's just brown, you don't see the reddish coming through. All right, let's slice this up. Ooh, listen to that. Sounds good. So here we have a little red, like a smoke ring, but the inside is soft and juicy. If you can see that, that is why it's so special. So at Argentina Sados, this is the first thing to disappear because it is incredible. And it's kind of like in barbecue. I remember the golden age when I could get Creekstone prime briskets for $2.99 a pound. Those days are long gone. And if you guys are early on getting these sweetbreads, you can remember the golden days of sweetbreads. But a little bit of lemon just on top. Smells so good. It's so good, man. It is so good. The bits of crunch in there are everything. All right, one more. Ah. Oh.
The whole thing, that's a big bite. Wow.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And you were skeptical.
Mm-hmm.
Even after I told everybody in the audience, I was like, it's so amazing, it's so good. And you're like, I'm gonna take a bite.
Oh. Daddy, I want some.
You wanna try some?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Are you ready, Emma?
Yeah. Hold on.
It's called mollejas.
Mollejas?
You try again? Mollejas.
Mollejas.
There you go. Can you say sweetbreads?
Sweetbreads.
There you go. You wanna try it?
Yeah.
You want a little bite or a big bite?
A big bite.
Okay, well, here you go. You can choose. Okay, taste it.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
What do you like better, this or steak?
This.
What do you like more, this or ribs?
Ribs.
What do you like more, ice cream or this?
Ice cream.
I knew I was going to lose that one. Brisket or this?
This.
I'm hurt. Shocked. But mostly hurt. You want another bite?
Yeah.
You see what my family thinks about it. Also, you should be aware, it does have a little bit of a mineral-like aftertaste. If you're into that, this is going to be the greatest thing you've ever eaten in your whole life. But if it's something that's really off-putting, then maybe it's not the right answer for you. But I would highly recommend you guys get out there and try some of these. These are veal sweetbreads, but if you can find nice big ones that you can grill up and get crispy on the outside, ideally you'd have something like a Santa Maria or an Argentine grill where you can get super high heat and get that crispy, kind of a little bit crunchy outside exterior, and you can dial it back if you need to. But for me, this is something I'm gonna be grilling very often in the future. Anyway, I encourage you guys to get out there and try it. If you enjoyed the video, you can hit the like button down below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, but it's called X now, and Patreon at Mad Scientist BBQ. I'll see you guys next time. And we're gonna slice this open. Drizzle, it's like sprizzle. No, it's not sprizzle. Sprinkle, drizzle, drizzle.